two sergeants, one corporal, 24 privates, one batman, six drivers, all 2,200. Shall jury act?
Tommies, 7th of October 1914, by Michael Chaplin.
A patch of earth in northern France. In the half-light of dawn, a nightingale sings its final aria from the edge of an ancient wood. After the night's rain, Alphonse Minet is ploughing the remnants of his wheat crop into the rich, loamy soil. The field slopes uphill to the wood. The sun rises. In this brief Indian summer, it's going to be another perfect day. For 150 years, the Minets have grown cereals for the bakeries of Rheims, 20 miles away. In that time, very little has changed in the valley of the Aisne. It is 6:48 on the morning of October the 7th, 1914. Monsieur Minet pays no attention to the lorry. Lost in the richness of his soil, he wonders if the harvest of 1915 can match this year's record. In fact, the field has been harvested for the last time in 6 years. Alphonse Minet won't live to see the next. He will be killed by a stray bullet fired by one of his own countrymen in January 1917.
Complete of his guilt. When he was sleeping, we were peeping to see how well he was built. Not again.
The lorry's fuel line is faulty. No minor inconvenience, as its driver has an appointment. Mickey Bliss is going to war for the first time.
What are you going to do now, Sergeant?
Stick your finger where you didn't alter.
Yeah, you can't exactly carry young contraption, can we?
Looks like your little mission's over before it began, Sergeant Bliss.
I'll fix it.
Sergeants Walter Oddy and Horace Greenwood are comparative veterans with 7 weeks' experience of conflict.
Morning, Sergeant. Problem?
Sir.
That's it, you see? The average horse doesn't break down.
Yeah, just like your average lorry doesn't get shot from under you.
Now you're for it, he heard you.
Your name?
Sergeant Michael Bliss, Signal Section, Lahore Division, Indian Army.
Ah, Bliss. Don't suppose you've heard that one before?
If I had a pound for every time, sir.
Didn't know you chaps were over here already.
Everyone but me isn't, sir, on troop ships in the Indian Ocean, last I heard. Will you excuse me?
Unlike normal soldiers, signalers find themselves seconded to other units whenever and wherever they're required.
So I'm playing nursemaid to your operation today.
Lieutenant Dunster?
It is he. Would you like a tow?
This proves unnecessary. Mickey Bliss is a consummate fixer, but not as skilled a map reader.
Now then, where are we?
Tell me you're lost.
In fact, the party is 2 miles north of the village of Bourg-et-Comin, which straddles the river Aisne and its accompanying canal.
Follow me, Sergeant. Lead on.
B Squadron of the 15th King's Hussars have been in France since the outbreak of war, acting variously as probing attack force and rear guard, picking up German stragglers and British deserters, riding nearly 200 miles in the pell-mell retreat from Mons and the counterattack on the Marne, the eyes and ears of 2nd Division.
Rendezvous point, Sergeant.
Now the front has settled just north of the Aisne. The horsemen of Lieutenant Dunster's troop have barely slept for 6 weeks.
You signal Wallace here for a spot of lamp flashing and flag waving, are you?
Something rather more sophisticated, sir. This.
And what is that?
One motor lorry set, straight from the factory.
Let me have a look.
Until now, the British Expeditionary Force has mostly used the telegraph to convey information at the front, which involved riders on horseback laying lines from carts over trees, buildings and other high points, all at the gallop.
Rather large, isn't it?
Indeed it is. The components of the wireless set, transmitter, mast and receiver, weigh 600 pounds.
It transmits Morse via a spark gap. It receives on a long wave Mark II tuner.
Range?
100 miles.
Good heavens.
Yeah, if it works.
It could make such a difference, sir. I mean, it's beautiful.
True believer, are you, Bliss?
Fast, effective communication will win the war, sir.
Not men on horseback, I presume.
I didn't say that, sir.
And the point of today's exercise?
Well, we test the set under field conditions, sir. Acquiring vital intelligence in the process.
What about you two? Are you trained to use the wireless like Sergeant Bliss here?
No, sir.
Here to observe, sir. And help with the umping.
Well, Sergeant Bliss, your show. Best get on with it.
The clear waters of the Musi tumble quickly from the heights of an escarpment to join the Aisne. Before the war, Sunday anglers caught trout in the Musi and carp in the Aisne. The artist, Camille Pizarro, painted the trees of the valley in autumn.
Be careful, Bliss. Got loads cover of them trees.
Bet some German's got his glasses on us right now.
It's now 7:55 a.m.
Far away then, Bliss.
So the enemy occupy the high ground up there.
Right along their chemin de dames. The ladies' path, but don't get too excited. The dames have long gone.
And the bastards have moved in, haven't they, sir?
So daintily put. And well established with artillery.
Well, that's the thing. We're to establish the position of their guns on that ridge and send the coordinates back to our artillery.
Oh, it sounds so bloody easy, don't it?
You see, Sergeant, your devilish Hun don't actually put his guns on the skyline.
Yeah, I realise that, sir.
But below it, on the other side.
So how do you reckon on peering through a bank of earth?
Well, we'd have a chance further up the hillside. You see the dip in the ridge? If we could find a vantage point and look at an angle through that dip, we might spot their guns.
But they'd see us, wouldn't they?
Well, look, according to the map, there's a tongue of woodland going almost all the way up to that ridge. We could get up there.
What, in that lorry?
Look, there's a track leading through the wood, you see? Past the house or farm, we'd be hidden.
Just one thing wrong with your plan, Sergeant Bliss.
What's that, sir?
Look downstream. The bridge taking us where you want to go.
In plain sight of the enemy.
Try crossing that and you'd be sending your last message.
They'd blow us to little bits.
Yes, yes, I see that.
Well, what now then, Sergeant?
Sam!
With you, Sergeant. What's the problem?
Look, just, look, take it easy, you two. Hey, you're bloody sniping in front of an officer.
I'll get him, Walter.
Stow it, Ollie. So, how long have you been in that Indian army of yours, then, Bliss?
Well, I thought there was a bit of a niff round here.
Look, I signed up in 1900, so...
So you'll win the long service medal. So tell us, any of your brown chums actually tried to kill you in the last 14 years?
What's your point?
My point is, me and him have done more soldiering in 2 months than you've ever dreamed of, sunshine.
Yeah, that's right.
Or this were a post office engineer before this started. I bet he's forgotten more than they ever taught you, Aldershot.
Yeah, we're not about a wireless set, he hasn't.
Cheeky sod.
Look. I'm just here to do a job the best I can. It's signals versus the rest, you remember? And I need your help to get it done. Come on, you want a smoke?
Thanks.
Right, go on.
Right then.
Lieutenant's compliments, Sergeant. Would you join him?
That's all they see with name, sir.
Whoa, Camille! You gave me a right start there.
You're English?
I am not. Scots and proud of it.
You live near here, miss?
Sister Catherine, if you please.
Sorry, excuse me.
Our convent's up the lane here.
Ah, the house on the map.
Look at you all. I don't know which looks grander, Lieutenant. Your men or their horses.
Have you encountered the enemy?
Oh, I saw plenty of the German lads before you pushed them up the hill.
Do they treat you with respect?
Oh, aye.
It's just, you know, your stories.
They're good Catholic farm boys from a place called Worms.
As in the Diet?
Sir?
The Rhineland.
Swineland, you mean, sir?
They helped Monsieur Minet get his harvest in.
So you're still here, between the lines?
We left when the fighting started, but Sister Therese and I came back to see to the garden. The orchard's hanging with fruit, and I'm manuring the vegetable beds before winter, as you've maybe noticed.
So you come and go across this bridge,
mm-hmm.
And they never bother you?
Why should they? It's peaceful here.
Sister, is there another way of crossing this stream?
Aged 18, the youngest of 5 children of a shipyard.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.